feel like that one more side just to get. Look what dog in me. Why must I feel like that one more star just to get. Look what the dog in me. Why must I feel like that one more star just to get. Look what dog in me.
Their first varsity win. You know what? What's going to happen tonight? They'll have to wait at least one more week. Defending Big Nine champs, rolling easy tonight. First possession, Lee Sims, 8 yards, barely touched, 7-0 Bulldogs. Three and out for the Suns. Then a 90-yard drive as they were boogied down as Edgar Brown. Kurt Morgan with the final 27 yards. All right, here he gives Jeremy McCarrigan a little ride for the final five or so. All. Pasco, 35-20. They get Richland next week.
Josh Schimmick goes to Lee Sims right into your living room. Touchdown, Pasco. And they would roll tonight, 35-20. So now the Bulldogs are 5-0. They join Wahai atop the Big Nine standing. 10 Pasco, fourth quarter now. Fourth down for Walla Walla, deep in their own end, and Pasco's Ippolita Malloy sacks Thompson for the safety. 2 points, Bulldogs.
For Pasco, Thompson now going deep, but Efren Ramos, nice interception at the 31-yard line. Pasco defense holds on that sequence. Fourth and two, Wahai late. Thompson backed up, and Ippolita Malloy ices the ball game. That, my friends, is called a safety.
15-10 is your final score. Pasco improves to 7-0. They are 15-0 in the Big Nine, or rather 14-0 in the Big Nine under Steve Graff. Wahai falls to 6-1.
I don't know. We just needed a big play at the end, and our team just got fired up and said, you know, we can win the game on defense, and that's what our coach has been telling us all year. So we went out there, and the hole opened up. I don't even remember what happened. We ended up in the end zone.
Yeah. 7, Kyle Nelson, and he comes up on the line.
Thank you. Truck online. Well, you're a youth, that's the truth. lines at the 25, breaks a couple of tackles. Headlock, I don't go. He could go all the way. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown.
Playoff spots in each league already decided, so the only question in some places, seeding, like in the Big Nine, where we know that Pasco, Walla Walla, Kamiakin, and Wenatchee are the four playoff teams. What we didn't know coming into tonight yet, though, well, who will finish where? First, the Bulldogs. Their task simple tonight. A win over Davis at Edgar Brown Stadium. We give Pasco a second straight league title. Minute to play, first half. Kyle Nelson in for Josh Schimmick. He hits Ippolito Molloy, 18 yards, 12-6, Bulldogs at the half. Now at halftime, Bob Gregson, who's been part of the Pasco School District for more than 40 years, appropriately honored. Congratulations, Mr. Gregson. Third quarter, Kurt Morgan with the short plunge, 19-7 Bulldogs, and they just poured it on. They were dancing at Edgar Brown. Schimmick comes back in, finds Chip Elfering on the 11-yard score. Pasco wins 33-14 to clinch the league title.
33-14 over Davis. They are the co-Big Nine champions for the second year in a row. They will be the number one seed, and they will host University High School on Tuesday night.
Hitman. body starts to break. You might miss the last step to a dance concept. K-Swing, I drop the power that'll keep you rocking after hours. Come on, y'all, let's turn it up and knock the bass up, operate the dance floor, jump up and down when the people start to yell. Yeah, no time to chill. Dance all night because you got to be strong. There it is, you got to move on. Shake and bake your money maker. And let me take you to a style that'll make you get down.
Second down now, 6 yards to go after Morgan got four. Two men to the right, Schimmick back to pass, setting up, looking for Niebel, setting, gonna gut it for Niebel, he's wide open on the 40, 35, 30, he's out in front of the 20, he will score! Schimmick back to pass, setting down the middle for Kane. You got him to the 40, 50, 45. He's out in front at the 30. After Miss Sizemore, forget it. Touchdown, Pasco.
first-round playoff contest. First stop, Edgar Brown Stadium, where the Big Nine champion Pasco Bulldogs hosted the U-High Titans, and woof, woof, here come the dogs. But I'll tell you what, and Kurt Morgan weaves and bobs and shuffles his way to a 29-yard touchdown. Again, the extra point no good, 6-6. Now 14-14, less than a minute before half, and it's Morgan again, second of three on the night. Pasco will lead 21-14 at half and pull away in the third quarter en route to a 42-21 win. The Bulldogs advance.
Pasco from there, Josh Schimmick play fake. Nice looking pass to Kyle Lamb. 21-14 Bulldogs, and they're just getting going. Second half, the Bulldogs pour it on. Kyle Nelson at the helm, and he delivers a strike to Brian Niebel. Nice catch for the touchdown. 42-21 is your final score. The Pasco Bulldogs move on with the win over U-High.
And then it all started. The Bulldogs advance right here. If you can follow the ball, that's what it is. It's Brian Niebel on the other end, 10 yards out, puts the Bulldogs up 7-0. And there would be plenty more where that came from today after Brandon Kinnear will recover the Wenatchee fumble right here at the 16. What you're about to see is a little deja vu, what we like to call it. This is not the same play I just showed you a minute ago. It's just we can't follow the ball. It's Josh Schimmick to Brian Niebel again. Remarkably similar play. Puts Pasco up 14-0, and they would go on to roll today. Your final 44-8. The Bulldogs will advance, and they will play the team I'm about to tell you about here.
Second TD connection for the two. Then in the second half, Ippolito Malloy would catch a touchdown pass. Bulldogs win it easily, 44-8.
We got the turnovers there that helped us get our offense more chances, and more chances our offense can get. We can score some points.
We just want to play a complete game. We've been playing not very good in the first half, and then second half's our stronger half. And we knew these guys were capable of coming back. Like they did first game of the season. So we just want to play a complete game today and play hard.
Going to run around the left side in the third quarter to give the Bulldogs the 28-14 lead. They win it 28-21. Bulldogs moving on in the playoffs.
Dreams are made up. Achieving that goal that you've thought about your whole life. The dream came true for the Pasco Bulldogs Saturday afternoon as they earned a spot in the 4A state title game for the first time ever. The Dogs ran over, around, and through the Cascade Bruins in the semifinals at Lamson Stadium. Third quarter, no score. Josh Schimmick up top to Brian Niebel. No defenders around him. Gone. 65 yards. Dogs led 7-0. In the fourth, Schimmick, Brandon Kenya. Turn around. Good choice. He picks it up and runs 71 yards. 14-0. Pasco wins it, and they advance.
How do you sum it up? We played great. Offensively, we had a couple miscues. We were able to overcome those. The defense played great.
This is awesome. Exciting. I've never had this feeling before. It's so much fun to know that we're going to go over and play in Tacoma. And we're the only, us and maybe one other team in 4A are playing right now. It's awesome. It's unexplainable.
Great. Nobody expected us to be here at all. We were picked fifth, as you know, and we just came out. It was 0-0. We just said we had to buckle down, and if we wanted to play next week, we had to do it in the second half, and we did it.
And the most important question, how are you guys feeling right now?
Oh, we're feeling good. We're feeling real good. We're going to the Dome. We're hopefully going to get number one in the state.
Held them down. They're getting the water bucket right now, fellas. You're going to get wet. You're going to get wet.
Let's get ready to rumble!
So on Saturday in the Tacoma Dome at 7:30, 12-1 Pasco will go gunning for their first ever football title against 12-0 Wilson.
And they don't have to snap it again.
And the Bulldogs rush with 12 seconds to go off the field, and the Cascade Bruins stand there seeing their season end. And the Pasco fans have jammed it. We had about 6,000 or 6,200 people here today. We'll be headed to the Tacoma Dome next week to play the winner of the Wilson-Snohomish game. Pasco has won 14-0.
picked us fifth in our league, and we kind of put that as, you know, we were the last year with the Big Nine champs. You know, we got a tough break in the state tournament last year, and this year we knew we could be the same team. You know, we had all our linemen coming back. We just got a great team, and we just believed in ourselves, and even when nobody else believed in us, we did.
And it's that believing that's giving Pasco a chance at its first state championship. The Bulldogs have shocked their league opponents, their local media, and now teams statewide. But they never shocked their supporters.
That's huge. It, I don't know how to just, you know, what to say, but everybody's behind us. We have a great crowd. Our kids show up to games, and it's fun for the whole school.
Yeah, our crowd stuck by us all year, thick and thin. You know, that can't say anything bad about Pasco fans. It doesn't matter. They're gonna be on your side no matter what.
And no matter what, these Bulldogs have given them reason to celebrate, and one of those big reasons is the purple and white defense. They have two shutouts this season and never allowed more than 21 points in a game.
The defensive guys did great. They've been played the team game all year. It's a team defense, and that's the way we sell it. Every guy takes care of his job, and we're successful.
Well, having a head coach as a defensive coordinator helps a lot. That's what we have, a good, decent defensive back coach. Coach Ped really coached the DBs up. A lot of teams can't throw the ball on us, and the front line helps them stop. We go over things every week, and we get the job done.
And one similarity between the offense and defense is the ability to make the big play. Especially at this level of playoffs, the team who shows it can break away from a tight battle keeps playing for more.
Made big plays. Every single time that the offense needs to make a big play, you know, a score, or the defense needs a big stop on third or fourth down, we've always done that all season long.
And they did it when it mattered most versus Cascade in the semifinal game. With the score tied at zero at halftime, someone had to break for a long score. And the Bulldogs were the ones to do it.
They were telling us it's going to be open, and you know, as soon as I seen it, nobody was on me, and he threw it. Luckily, he led me, and from there I just foot raced and I beat the guy.
Along with the big plays, it's a lot of dedication that makes a state championship caliber team.
These kids have worked hard in the off season with spring football and in the weight room, and it's a credit to them. They did a great job.
It feels great. You know, it's been a dream of ours since we were little. We've always said we were gonna be here, and now we are. It feels real good.
Plotting and planning, so you can see it boiling in here.
I don't know, I just want to get it started right now.
You're anxious?
Yeah, a little anxious. That's about it.
Get out there and kick some butts around, huh?
Yeah.
Pasco has the top defense in the Big Nine. They also feature a three-receiver set and explosive offense. One of these teams will take home its first championship tonight. It's the Rams and the Bulldogs next.
Good game last week, at least in terms of productivity. Had two long touchdown passes in their 14-0 win, 65-yarder and a 71-yarder. 3 for 8, 147 yards, two touchdowns and two interceptions to get his team into the championship game.
Nebel, the up back, got four on the first play. Morgan, the tailback, is now in motion. Nebel again, left side, has some room over the 35 before he's tripped up.
Five gave lots of room to Ryan Nebel.
Not only now he's out to the outside, he's their leading receiver with 49 catches. As Morgan, the leading rusher, gets it this time, he'll rip off another eight or so before he is brought down. Nebel, just to finish that last point, had only carried the ball 18 times before tonight's game, and he carries on the first two. But this is the guy who'll do the buck of the groundwork tonight.
Yeah.
He's attempted 78 passes for the season, so that's 6.5 attempts a game. Why? Because he's got Trufant right there. Nice initial tackle by the All-State linebacker, Scott Smiley. Patchens, the tight end, is split out to the right as they go to a trips formation. Blitz, fumble. Pasco on top of the ball. The initial hit made by Ippolito Molloy. He got Robinson on the backside and caused the fumble. Kania recovers it for the Bulldogs.
Both these teams play lots of game on AstroTurf. That's not an issue, but they're going to have to get used to how quickly these Wilson players can go.
Robinson loses the ball. He didn't tuck it away. Pasco got a helmet on it, and the Bulldogs have forced a second turnover.
Two turnovers in less than a quarter.
A little different look for the Bulldogs this time. Roll out by Schimmick. Throws Elfering. He lined up to the left side, just did a drag route across and was open. Brought down by Stevens, and a nice conservative passing play for Pasco. Time finds his favorite receiver, Nebel. Schimmick is the holder. Lance Kostoff, who got a field goal versus Wenatchee in the playoffs, partially blocked, but gets it through. 25-yard field goal, and Pasco is on the board. Trufant in motion out to the flat. Robinson throwing, batted down by Smiley. Nice play by the backer. Third and nine for the Rams from the shotgun. Robinson looking deep middle, overthrows his man, intercepted by Efren Ramos. Ramos with his ninth interception of the season. Takes it to the Wilson 49-yard line. Third turnover by the Rams.
Well, that's what happens when you force Wilson, too, into a third and long situation, a third and nine. And Ahmad Robinson with a nice spiral, but not a very good decision right there. Got time to throw and then just kind of throws it up for grabs. Again, it's deep coverage. You see both safeties just hanging around back there. That's the 22nd interception of the year for this Pasco defense.
Third and long situation again. Floating pocket, a good idea. Wide open. First down, and the catch made by Chip Elfering. They'll run it again with Morgan. Best run of the night probably for him as he's finally dropped in the secondary by Pataro.
It's a lot to remember out there.
Wait, you're standing up for centers? Throwing back for Morgan at the 25, broke a tackle inside the 10, hauled down by Pataro to save the touchdown. It'll be first and goal, Pasco.
Yeah, they don't throw it very often, but when they do, they make big plays out of it. Play action, because you've been running the ball successfully, is effective, and Wilson, again, just seems to lose track of the guy. See the fake to Morgan, then he carries it out to the left, and there's nobody out there wearing blue.
You guess it's the backer who's trying to chase him from behind there who missed the read. They've gone 63 yards so far and run off a lot of clock. Morgan inside the five, touchdown Pasco.
The big guys seal off the inside and the little guys get good blocks on the outside. Morgan does a great job of lowering his pads and looking for goal line. See on the left side here, just sealed off inside. Nobody coming around. Jonathan Kovas and buddies do a job. And Nebel on lead block. Morgan with tonight's first touchdown.
Point after is good by Lance Kostoff. And with 1:32 to play in the first half, the Bulldogs have broken it open 10-0.
Pulled a hamstring, though.
He's got to come up with something here for his team as they've got just a few ticks to deal with. Robinson finally goes down. Second effort. Again, Ippolito Molloy, who has been in the backfield all night, has generally missed Robinson, but this time he hung on. This time, Trufant on first down will not get anywhere. Backside pressure again by Ippolito Molloy, along with support from the corner, Jermaine Johnson. Pitch for Trufant. He's swarmed under again. Pasco brought everybody that time, and he's dropped clear back at the 11-yard line.
Yeah, look at those guys run. Unbelievable pursuit right there. Once again, Ippolito Molloy is in the backfield, forces Robinson to pitch it very quickly. Brian Niebel and his Bulldog mates, you see just the speed of Molloy to make that play, and then how good a defensive player is Brian Niebel.
They don't need to get it all, but they've got to make some kind of dent. Watch for Stevens to the left. They're going to fade route for him in the corner. Wide open is Ramos, and he makes the interception. He was there. He was backpedaling before the snap, Chuck, and was in perfect position.
Well, again, a third and long situation, one that Wilson doesn't like to be in. Stevens split left. Looks like he has man coverage over there with Kyle Nelson, but Ramos is back there deep as well. Stevens doesn't get off the line of scrimmage. He and Kyle Nelson, you can see, get tangled up, and down goes.
It wouldn't have mattered,
Stevens,
though, folks.
Unless Stevens can make a serious play on that ball. Ramos with his second of the night, his 10th of the year. And once again, Wilson turned away. First and goal at the 2-yard line, and they come up empty.
Fourth turnover of the night for the Rams. Kurt Morgan off the left side. Close to first down yardage. He got 9 on it on second and 14. Over the middle, Niebel. First down inside the 25-yard line. Robinson on the stop along with Sean Pattero. Steve Graff said, when we need a first down, when we gotta have one, this is the guy we go to.
Yeah.
Kyle Nelson to the top of the screen. Niebel's in the slot. Underneath, catch, touchdown. Wilson got fooled and Nelson broke in. The defenders were camped out waiting for the ball. There is a flag thrown late in the Pasco backfield.
Yeah, late enough, I don't think it's a...
The touchdown counts.
I don't think it's a holding.
It should be unsportsmanlike, perhaps. After the pass, let's see, there is no signal yet. Chuck, the Wilson defenders were waiting for the ball, and all of a sudden, there came Nelson to make the catch for the touchdown. Now, the other thing is perhaps Schimmick said something as you saw him tap his chest.
Dead ball, unsportsmanlike. It's going to go on the throttle. Oh, excuse me, it's against the white team.
It is against Pasco, and I think Schimmick might have gotten a little fired up after the touchdown pass to Kyle Nelson.
You can see Schimmick, as he has done almost all night, went a big down, looking for Niebel, looking for Niebel, and it's Nelson that cuts back underneath. Again, a misdirection passing play with everybody chasing Niebel to the corner and Nelson sneaking back underneath across the middle, and a great throw with good protection from Josh Schimmick.
Just when the Rams appeared to be trying to make it a ball game, the turnovers strike again. Pasco's ball when we come back. Second and 8 now for the Bulldogs, and it's Morgan once again. Nice lead block. He'll pick up the first down. A great lead block for Morgan that time by Jonathan Kovas, the 6'1", 230 senior.
Done a great job tonight of getting Morgan a lot of those yards. You see, the holding penalty in the previous play got him second and long, but they still want to run the clock. I mean, look at this. He's just rambling through that backfield like he's running through the park, through the trees. There's nobody back there to make a play. He blocked the line of scrimmage. The downfield guy's making good blocks as well.
He gives it ahead to Kyle Lamb. He's knocked down on the line of scrimmage. That'll be your last play of the game. Pasco is closed for the next week. The celebration is on. The Pasco Bulldogs are the 1998 state football champions. At midfield, they mob each other. This is absolutely the greatest moment in the history of Pasco. Go ahead, Jim.
Frank, I'm with Kurt Morgan. 31 carries. What do you think of all that?
That's a great win. Offensive line setting it up. We did We did what everybody, what all the team knew we could do, what everybody back home thought we could do. We did it. We came through.
How's the hand feel?
It's sore. It's sore. It's not going to be feeling good in the morning, but it's feeling good right now.
Got to be a happy end. Kurt, go celebrate. Frank?
Okay, you take it whatever you want it, Jim.
All right.
Get your hand.
Jermaine. Frank, got Jermaine Johnson. You were even still counting those seconds down with 1 minute to play.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah. This is a big surprise. No one expected us ever to get here. Now, look. State champ, shutout. Oh, you can't ask for any more. I can't ask for any more.
How's it feel to stand on the 50-yard line in the state champ?
Oh, it feels great. It feels great.
Congratulations, Jermaine Johnson. Frank, why don't you take a break, and I'll come back in a minute.
Okay, we're going to wrap it up, come back for the fifth quarter. We're going to be here all night. Let's take the end of the game broadcast. Fifth quarter coming up. Pasco, your state champion. The Dogs 17, Wilson nothing.
Can you remember back to a simpler time? Back to the watercolor days that still run through your mind. Oh, I remember just my old friend and me running through an open field the way it used to be. Feeling that our hearts just take wings, we could live out all our dreams. The journey there was never far away, but like a dream come true, that's still inside of you. The secret of tomorrow is to live your dreams today. Remember, remember the magic.
50. How does it feel, Brian?
Feels great. So all I can say, I'm in shock.
What was the game plan going in? You shut out Cascade, you shut out Wilson. No question who's number one, eh?
No question. We just came out hard. We knew they had some great athletes. I mean, number one, number 41, and 15, our quarterback, they're all great athletes. They're the best three we've seen on one team. We just try to do our best, read our keys. We did a great job on defense.
We knew they had great speed and great talent, you know, but we knew if we played like we did all year, we'd be all right.
Yeah, and you can't believe the feeling. This is great.
That's pretty big. You know, I knew from his formation he was going on a 93, and I was lucky to be there. You know, Kyle Nelson had a great jam on him, and he stumbled and fell, and, you know, and it was only me there. Yeah, you know, the turning point. Yeah, that's a huge play, I think. One of the biggest, and, you know, I'm just lucky it was me.
What about the season?
It's been great, you know. I mean, the whole year we've had these great fans in back of us, and, you know, to go 12 and or whatever and one, it's awesome. I love it.
Yeah, our defense stepped it up a bunch this game. Everyone seemed to come together as a team. Everyone just did their job. Beginning of the season, people were too worried about everyone else's responsibilities, and everyone just came together as a team. And I don't know, we really keyed on 1, 15, and 41. They're great athletes. And I don't know, we shut them down, and the rest is history, I guess.
The rest is history. You like holding that trophy?
Oh, man, it's the greatest thing I've ever done in my life. It's the greatest day. I don't know. Can't believe we did it.
You know, because everything was questionable, and I was going to get one shot. And, you know, that one shot is all you can ask for. And they gave it to me, and the Lions stepped it up and made it easy for me.
Coming into this ball game, were you guys at all, everybody made so much of what this team had that you're playing Wilson undefeated and all these Division I prospects, but you guys didn't seem at all intimidated.
Oh, no, not at all. We know all season with the type of players that we have that the team's going to win the game. You know, not individual players aren't going to win the game. So that's what we figured. You know, we just play hard. We wanted to be in the ball game in the fourth quarter within striking distance. And once we got into the fourth quarter, we knew it was ours.
I want to really say hi to my wife, Charlotte, and our baby son, Trevor Scott. I miss you very much, and I love you both. I'll be home soon. I'm flying out tomorrow morning at 8:30, and I'll be home at 9:30. So we'll see you when I get there.
You played in this league, and even though it was at Kennewick, I know you're wearing purple tonight, and there's so much history in your family and playing in the Tri-Cities. This has to be very special to you.
Oh, this is unbelievable. It's, you know, it's one of the greatest wins ever, you know, in my coaching career.
Happy man tonight.
This is just incredible, Jim. I think these kids have made us awfully proud. Every week we just weren't sure where it was going to go next. And did you look up in the stands tonight? Did you see the number of people who are here from Pasco? There must have been 5,000 or 6,000 people here. These kids have really created a lot of interest from our fans, and it's well deserved.
And I know you must be a proud rep. I know you get to run this school district, but it's kind of nice to come over here and show off what Pasco has to offer, isn't it?
We do what we do because of the kids, and when they perform like they did tonight, it's just an incredible feeling.
Well, I think that's about sums it up, George. Thanks very much.
You bet, Jim.
That's a pretty good deal.
Pretty good deal.
Yeah. Well, hey, it's fun. Those kids have worked really hard at it, and it's a credit to them.
Yeah. Yep. Great season.
Thanks.
We're not even home today, just to get on a stand. Hey.
Trying to sneak in. I'm sorry.
Finally got our
way down. Yeah.
We were just going crazy outside. Dad. It's like you lost your voice.
You kind of got like that.
A little bit.
Yep.
Yeah.
Neat. Like
pretty awesome. Good job, Josh.
It's a comfort thing.
Good job.
It's pretty fun.
Now you can go play basketball, huh?
Yeah, hopefully. Can play here again someday. Yeah.
What a man, what a man, what a mighty good man.
gotta keep them separated.
Football championship that Pasco won on Saturday night was the first ever for the school and the first in any sport in Pasco since 1951. And this afternoon, the party continued with a school-wide pep rally as each player got introduced to what was a raucous crowd. And Coach Graff tried to put his players' accomplishment into perspective.
Ho-hum, just another championship.
Oh, come on.
These guys were picked to finish fifth in our league. They surpassed that. We set some goals to be playing on Thanksgiving. We did that. Took care of business against the Cascade. And, the last two teams we played, the two top scoring teams in the state, they got nothing against us. Everybody to come over and watch us. These guys standing out here have been doing football since last year when we lost that game to CB. They've been in the weight room. They've been out in spring football. They spent a week in the summer at camp. And it's a tribute to them. Nobody believed in them except for the people in purple and white. And we got it done. Thank you. And you notice most of the coaches on staff got the high and tight haircut with the exception of Coach Pedersen.
Everything will help you. Your head. Good job, right up there.
Watch out. Time of your life. something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
And there it is. It's already official and engraved forever. Pasco, 1998. And I'm sure similar engravings are being made for the B-11, B-8, and two-way trophies by Othello, DeSales, and Tucci as well. Congratulations to everyone.
You're so unbelievable. You're unbelievable. Unbelievable.